Hi everyone and welcome back. So we are going to start the front-end architecture, like how we are going to organize the components, how their component communication will happen, what will be the container component, what will be the DOM component, how we are going to decide the layouts, routing, all these things. Okay, so what we decided is we are going to adopt atomic design for writing the React application. First of all, what is this atomic design? Atomic design means where you can identify the components, you can create atoms, molecules, organisms, templates, all these things, right? Because when we talk about any React component, right, we should be able to divide things into atom, molecules, organism, page, and template, right? Page is the bigger element, then we have a template, then we have an organism, then we have molecules, and then atoms, right? We should be able to divide each and everything inside an individual component, like button, like text field, these can be a component, then accordion, right? Then there is a form can be a organism, then there is a template, and then there is a login page, right? So these are organized into this form: page, template. Page is the bigger one, then template, then organism, then molecules, and the atoms is the smallest unit, like button can be an atom, the label can be an atom, okay? Any kind of icon, SVG icons, buttons, all these can be considered as atom. So finally, this is our template where we are actually organizing all these molecules together, organisms together, and then it becomes a page. So page is a larger entity which consists of all the templates, and template contains some multiple organism which contains molecules and then atoms, right? So I recently adopted this design in few of my React applications, and it works very nicely, right? I created a template generator so that you can create a molecules by just command. You can create atoms in the atoms folder, templates, pages in the pages folder. So we are going to adopt this strategy only. What we are going to do is we are going to use create React app, and we are not going to use for now material UI and all. We are going to write our own sass. Okay, we are going to write a simple sass. We can adopt a storybook later. Okay, CSS, we are going to use a variable object, and create React app automatically handles the compilation with the help of Webpack and Babel. So we don't need to worry about all these things. What we need to worry about is a component organization and the routing, because routing, lazy loading, all those optimization features which we can adopt while writing the code. Okay, so in the next video, we will start our code. We will just create a baseline of our React application with the generators, so that if there is a new developer, he want to create a new page with the command line like Angular CLI, which helps you to create a service component and all these things, we should be able to create our custom generators, like you want to create page, template, organism, atoms, molecules, with the test cases associated with it. We are going to use Jest and Engine for the testing. Okay, so we are going to adopt this architecture, then we will decide, okay, we are going to do the class-based component or the functional component. We need hooks, we need context APIs, or do we need Redux? I want to keep it simple, okay? I want to use just a context APIs, and I can just combine use reducer with the context for state management, okay? We are not storing anything on the local storage or any in the React store. Like we can use recoil, we can use Redux. I want to keep it simple. I want to use more over these React hooks, which are now popular, like use effect, use state, use reducer, use context, all these hooks. And I want to make more functional components and make my application look cleaner. Okay, so let's get started, guys. Thanks everyone, thanks for watching. In the next video, we will do the baseline.